Hi everyone, it's Samavar here from Kipoas Studio. This video is about to show you how to make an embossed and debossed letterpress effect in Photoshop. The result will be an embossed and debossed letterpress text effect with a velvet leather image as the background. So to get started, open your background image by going to File, Open, Browse your background image file, and double click on it. Now we are going to make some text, so activate the type tool, adjust the font size, and here I select the smooth one. Then I pick the black color for the text. By the way, the text color is optional. You might want to pick another color you like. Select any font style to your liking and start making the text onto the canvas. In this demonstration, I make two different text layers. One is for an embossed letterpress effect and the other one is for a debossed letterpress effect. So I want to move the embossed text layer to the top. To move any text or adjust its position, make sure you select the text layer and activate the Move tool. If you want to align the text position horizontally, press Ctrl A and click this icon. Use your down arrow key to move it downward. So do with the other text layer. Like so. Now, firstly, we are going to make an embossed letterpress effect. So select the text layer you want to emboss, then click the effects icon and select blending options. Reduce the fill opacity amount to 0, then activate the bevel and emboss. Change the style to emboss, technique smooth, with depth amount around 250, direction up, size 5, and soft tone 1. Then adjust the shading according to the light perspective of your image, and use it as the global light so that you will no longer bother to set the light direction for the other style settings. Then make sure the highlight mode is green. Adjust the opacity amount until it looks corresponds to the brightness of the background. And the shadow mode is multiply. Select this opacity gauge to adjust its intensity. Then activate the inner shadow. So, because we are going to make an embossed text effect, give it white. With multiply blend mode, adjust the opacity to around 30%. Use the global light settings we just created in the previous style. Then distance to around 5. And size 32. So the value for these settings depends on your text size. Then activate the color overlay. Once again, because I'm going to make an embossed effect for this text layer, so I give it white. Change the blend mode to overlay. Set the opacity amount to around 33. If you are done, click OK. That's for the embossed text effect. Now let's make a debossed text effect for the other text layer. So select the text layer, click the effects icon, and select blending options. Reduce the opacity amount until 0. Activate the bevel and emboss style. Style emboss. Technique smooth with depth 250. And now select down for the direction with soft tone 1 and size 5. Once again, the adjustments for these settings depend on your text size. Make sure you use the global light. Then follow these remaining settings. Now activate the inner shadow. Because I am going to make a debossed text effect, so I give black for the color with multiply blend mode. Adjust the distance and the size amount while keeping an eye on the image changes until you're happy with the result. Then activate the color overlay and give it black as well. Make sure the blend mode is overlay and adjust the opacity amount. That's for the debossed text effect. And lastly, but optional, you might also want to add a lightning effect to the entire image. There are many ways to make a lightning effect in Photoshop, but this time I'm going to use a curves adjustment layer. Adjust the curves axis downward if you want to dim the lightning effect, and if you want to add a spotlight, select the layer mask of the curves, activate the brush tool, select the soft round brush, adjust the brush size with opacity 100%, flow 100%, and smoothing 100%. Make sure the foreground color is black, then brush or click on the same location onto the canvas several times until you get the lightning intensity you want for the spotlight effect. And finally, this is the result. Alright, that's all for this tutorial. If you have something to ask, please let me know in the comment section below. Hit the subscribe button for more future uploads. And as always, thanks for watching this video and see you around.